Hello everyone, you're welcome to my tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to draw the circle skirt. There are different types of circle skirts. We have the full circle, which is referred to the 360 degree circle. We have the half circle, which is also 180 degree circle. Then we have the quarter circle, which is the 90 degree circle. So I'm going to make these tutorials in series so that you'll be able to get everything you need to get from this class. Today I'll be dwelling on the full circle, which is a 360 degree circle. Before I continue, I would like to say that this 360 degree circle can be doubled. In case you need more fullness, you can equally make it two and join it together, which will give you your 720 degree circle. For your wedding dresses and ball dresses, you can even make it 4 times 4, which is like your 1440 degree circle. So for today's tutorial, which is the 360 degree circle full circle skirt, we'll be needing two important measurements, which are the waist measurement and the length of the skirt. I would like to say this, that when I say skirt, that doesn't mean that it has to be skirt. You can attach your flare to your sleeve. You can make it, can even use your flare to make a sleeve. You can add your flare to your blouse as a peplum. You can add it to the knee level. So it doesn't really mean that you have to sew it as a skirt. It can be used for different things, but today I'm dwelling on the skirt. So I'm using a waist measurement of 28 inches. Then I'm using a length of 20 inches. So this waist of 28 inches, you add 2 inches to it for your zipper allowance. You know, 1 inch will go for one side, 1 inch will go for the other side, making it 2 inches. When you add your 2 inches to the 28, that's 30 inches. So the waist measurement now will be 28 plus 2, which is equals to 30. Then we'll be working with a length of 20 inches. This is 20 inches. You have to add your hemming allowance to it. If you're going to use half inch, you add, it's going to be 20.5. If you're using 1 inch, then you use 21 inches. Okay. Before we get into the class, I would like to say that if you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Click on the like button, and please share my tutorials. Thank you. Then let's get into it. So here, now what you do is you bring your pattern paper like this. Your 30 inches divided by 6.28 is the standard for all medium, for all circumference. So that's 6.28. you say your waist measurement 28 plus 2, which is 30. 30 divided by 6.28, I've done my own calculation, it's 4.77, approximately 4.8 inches. So you take your tape measurement like this. My paper is not wide enough, so I'll just assume it's 1/2 inches. From the edge of the paper, you take, okay, let me just assume it's 1 inches, one like this. You go, you mark one from the edge like this, one. But remember that the actual one is 4.8 though. I'm just using one because of the size of my paper. So you do one all the way, one all the way, and you connect all the points together like this. So here we've gotten our radius, our quarter waist. So from this point, now we take our 20 inches length plus the hemming allowance, say 20 inches plus 0.5 inches for the hemming allowance, which is 20.5. But for the size of my paper, I would like to say that 20.5 is 4. So I'll do 4 here. 4 here. From this line, you keep marking it all around. 4 here. 4 here. 4 here, and you mark it all around. You can use your hand to connect. You can use your hand to connect the dot, or use your curve ruler to do it like this. You connect like this and like this. Here you have it. Your length from here to here is your length plus 0.5 inches for hemming allowance. So go back to the waist side. You know, you're going to attach a band to this waist, and you need your sewing allowance. So what you do now is, at this place, you measure 1/2 inch up, 0.5, all the way like this. So here is your seam allowance. This is your seam allowance for joining the band to the skirt. So here you cut like this. Can you see? You cut like that. Then here you cut like this. So this is it here, like this. So you bring your fabric like this. Let's say this is your fabric. This is your fabric like this. You fold it into two, and you fold it again like this. Fold it like this again. Notice this side is, there's no join here, but here this side has double folded, and there's opening here. You place it like this. Here you place, make sure that this side align with this side. So can you see? Sorry, the length was not wide enough for me to show you how to cut this place, but I'll just assume that this is it here. So you see this place that is double, you're going to leave that side. This side that is like this now, you take your scissors and open up one side like this and cut it through. This represents your center back, where you're going to fix your zip. Can you see? This will be where you fix your zip, right here. So you can see the fullness. This is your full circle, 360-degree circle. So this is it for today, guys. If you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.